I'm back at it, working with the 6x6 gel press plate, this time exploring ways to add texture to paint before pulling a print. I'll also show you how to print layers that have dried on the plate to create really interesting patterns and texture. I'm working with my gel press print plate again, and today it's the 6x6 size. I started thinking about convenience, and then I started to think about texture, and I know that doesn't necessarily seem like those are two things that belong together, but let me tell you how they really do. From a convenience standpoint, I got to thinking, this is a 6-inch by 6-inch gel press plate. These are 6-inch by 6-inch Strathmore artist tiles. This happens to be Bristol paper, and this happens to be black paper. And I thought, well, from a convenience standpoint, it's nice some of the time if I don't have to monkey around in pre-cut papers, I have them ready to go. A 6x6 gel plate, 6x6 papers, I'm good to go. I don't even have to think about that. So that's a really big advantage. And then it was all about texture. And so when you look at, this is our flourish stencil. When you look at this design, when you look at the white areas that represent the openings of the stencil, they're flat. I've removed the paint from the openings, through the openings from in the stencil using a piece of paper, which pulls it off in a really even pattern. But what happens if you use something that's textured, like this piece of paper towel? And that's the first thing that I want to start with. So I have Liquitex Basics. This is the light blue-violet color. There's nothing dramatic here. All I want to do is show you how interesting this can get if you go ahead, if you go ahead and you use something like paper towel. Sometimes it's not the big dramatic discoveries that really shed new light on ways to work. Sometimes it's the little silly ones. I picked up a piece of paper towel to blot through the openings in a stencil because I couldn't find a blank piece of paper to do it with, and I discovered that it made this really cool texture. Now I'm off to the side. I'm brayering the excess paint off of my brayer using deli paper, and I have plans for these deli papers. I've accumulated a lot that have just that layer or two of paint on them, and I just need to get in there and do something more with them. So again, this is our flourish stencil. I'm going to take this piece of paper towel, which conveniently is 6 inches. When you pull these little selecta sheets off of the roll, it comes out in a six inch width. Don't try to say that 5 times fast. And you can already see what's happened. I have all this texture from here. So there are some areas where I didn't do a really good job lifting the paint out. I want to go back and lift more of it out. Now you can go, if there is a bridge too far here, you can actually take so much of the paint out that you lose most of the texture, so it's one of those you have to kind of pay attention things. Alright, so with that done, I'm gonna grab, I've pulled these 6x6 artist tiles are glue bound into a pad, so I've pulled a bunch off. I'm gonna take the stencil off and get it out of the way. Now, rounded corners versus square corners, I'm not really worried about that. I'm also, obviously, I want this on as straight as possible. I don't want it off and really canted to one direction or the other. But if I use this, it's very likely that I'm going to cut it down to use it. So all I want to do is eyeball this to the best I can and go ahead and get it on the plate and then just rub so I can pull this print. And you immediately see the difference. So here is the texture generated, I could grab this other one, the texture generated by the paper towel versus the smooth white in the openings that you get when you just use paper. So again, this is not earth-shattering, but it definitely affords you options when you're deciding how to blot paint through the openings in a stencil. There are lots of ways to create texture, so let me show you how I can do that with, these are new foam stamps. This is kind of a wobbly, uneven circle, and this is called Bubbles. I'm going to start by putting one color on the plate. I'm going to texture it, and then I'm going to let it dry. In order for this technique to work, you have to let your first layer dry before you come back and you apply the second one. So I'm just going to get this spread out in a nice even layer on the plate. All right, so in come the stamps. So let's just play a little bit. Now the key with this is that if you are going to lift paint off, you have to do it every time. How cool is that? You have to do it every time with a clean stamp or it really won't lift all that well. So let's just come in and lift the bubbles off again. And then we can come in with this uneven circle and maybe put a mark there and then maybe a couple other marks and see how that goes. I am also going to bring in one of the Catalyst contour tools. I just want to make some lines in the other areas here. So we'll kind of do that and then just put some lines on. And as I said, the key is going to be letting this dry. So I will get these lines on. Well, I will get these lines on. There we go. I will let this dry and then I'll come back and I'll show you what to do next. With this first layer dry, I can come back and add another. And for this one, I have medium magenta. If I didn't say it previously, this color is light blue violet. All right, so I'm just going to get a layer applied. And if I think this is too much paint, I will brayer some of it off. We'll see what it looks like when I get it spread out. And no, this isn't going to be too much. I think it'll be just fine. What I'm going to do is move reasonably quickly, because obviously this is acrylic paint and it will dry. Never when you want it to, always when you don't, of course. This is Margaret Applin's Endless Stencil. Because I don't want any texture in the openings, I'm going to use just plain old scratch paper for this. This is just inexpensive printer paper. And I want to do two things. The first one is I want to remove the paint from around the stencil. I mean, that's my ultimate goal, but the other thing that I would like to do is see if I can actually not just pick up some of the magenta, but pick up some of the blue at the same time. And you can see that that's happening a little bit, so I'm going to come back and rub again. Kind of take a peek again and see what this looks like. Perfect. All right, so there we go. I've not only taken off color around the stencil, I've actually taken some of that initial blue color off. So before this gets too dry and the process doesn't work, let me flip off that stencil, bring in one of the pre-cut white Bristol pieces, and go ahead and print what's on this plate. Now obviously you can change the dry time by using something like Golden Open Acrylics or by adding a medium to your paint that would affect the time it takes to dry and slow it down a little bit. But how cool is that? You can see the texture from what I put down in the blue when I used this stamp. That's what you see here. You can see the marks that I made with the Catalyst tool, and then of course you can see the pink that remained underneath the stencil, because of course I blotted off everything else. Now interestingly enough, you can see in places that I did manage to, and let's bring this in, you can see that not only did I pick up the pink in places, but I picked up some of the violet, and that's how you get these open areas. The key to this technique when you want to pick up a previous layer is that you really must let that first layer dry completely. Now this is the same thing. I did these twice. This is the same colors and the same stencil and the same process, but you can see how different they appear. This is one of the most interesting things about working with the gel press plates and making monoprints. You almost never get the exact same results twice. You can come close, but you get wonderfully diverse results when you play with this product. The last technique I want to show you today is working with metallics and that black paper. It's the same 6x6 size. It's nice and smooth, so it will work. It's not quite as heavy as the Bristol white version, but really, it doesn't make a darn bit of difference. It works really well. It's nice and smooth. That's the most important thing. So this is the Copper Liquitex Basics. This is a metallic color. It's really, really pretty, and you can see that I've left the previous stuff on the plate. I'm hoping I can get it to print this way. So let's go ahead and brayer this on in a nice even layer. All right, now for this to really show and look like something, I'm going to come back. This is our Floral Fantasy Mask. I'm going to remove some of the color, just as I've done previously. For this one, I think I'll go back and use paper towel. Let's try that and see how that works so we get some additional texture. That should be fun. All right, that looks pretty darn good. Maybe right there, let's lift this off, bring in the black paper and print and see what this thing looks like. Give this a good rub so we get good contact. Take a peek. starting to see some of that color come up, so I'm going to leave it on there maybe another 15 or 20 seconds. Just going to continue to apply some pressure while I do that. Off it comes. Oh, how cool is that? You see the pattern of the stencil. You see the original pattern of what was left on the plate from Margaret's Endless stencil, and you get this wonderful glimmer effect, of the metallic paint, because you really see it working on this black piece of paper. So there you go. We're working with metallics, we're working with some interesting techniques, lots of texture, and then the ultimate convenience, having these pieces pre-cut to size so nobody has to mess around and cut them.